This here is a picture of my friend who is currently walking in the French Alps. He's raising some money, a friend of mine called Diotour. So this picture here I took of him when me and my friend Anthony went to West Wales to photograph him up this particular mountain. This is the behind the scenes picture. So you can see my friend Anthony, we sort of lugged up some lighting up onto this mountain to light him. However, you can see, obviously, this is the picture behind the scenes and this being the final out-of-camera picture. The reality was this. This was the final image. This was the out-of-camera image before I then worked on it. The reason I did it this particular way was, to the left-hand side of where Di stood, there was a family who just happened to follow us up this mountain, as they do, and they were having a picnic and their young kid was flying a drone. To the right-hand side of Anthony, who's holding the light in, the actual rocks just leveled off and there was a plain, boring, flat, grassed area. So it wouldn't have looked dramatic. That also the fact that I couldn't go any further back, because if I had, I'd have gone flying. It was a long drop. So I had to do it in portrait orientation and then work on it. So this was the out of camera shot. We had to try and match the lighting because it was very overcast. We used the hard light, slightly aimed off dice, so the soft side of it was hitting him. So he got nice softish light. But obviously you still get the shadows. The remove tool on there worked wonders to remove this particular shadow that was cast from this walking cane on his leg. It removed the actual shadow, but kept all the texture and stuff in his trousers, which kind of blew me away. But let's have a look at how I then created the actual wider picture, because there are options, obviously. We know that we've got the crop tool, and nowadays we have this generative expand option, but the problem with that is this, which we'll all know. Let's just unlock this layer. Actually, if I want to make this a bit of a wider panoramic landscapey kind of shot, we'll press enter. Automatically Photoshop Generative Fill expand kicks into action and it'll start to make the image wider. And if you looked at it on Instagram, you might think that looks pretty cool until you zoom in. And that is the current issue with the Generative Fill technology. Because obviously what we're getting out of Generative Fill is low resolution, 1024 by 1024 pixels. So although that looks good, when I zoom in, let's just close that down. This area on the right-hand side is the original image. Then you've got the image that's been generated on the left, and you can see a marked difference. It's blurry, it's out of focus, because it is such a low resolution. So let's just revert this back to normal, file, and revert. That'll take us back to the original image of Di. And if we look at the actual image size of this, the height of this actual picture is 9,504 pixels. So when we talk about generative fill only being at the best resolution when you create a square area of 1,024 pixels by 1,024 pixels, just to do the height in one strip would take 8 selections, roughly, all the way up the top, just to do a slight area on the side. All right, so let me show you a bit of a workaround that we could have. I'm not going to say necessarily to speed up the process, because why do we have to do this quick? Unless you're doing something that's a paid job and you're working by the hour or whatever, or you're working to a deadline, then really, I would suggest just slow down, enjoy it. Most people, I think it's fair to say that use Photoshop, do so because they just love doing it, and it's good fun, all right? So slow down, enjoy it. So what I'm going to do with this one, I'll unlock the layer. And the first step I'm going to do this so that we can get the best possible results out of Generative Fill, I'm going to go to Image and go to Canvas Size. And here we have the width and the height. And what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to increase the left, camera left. Let's increase that. Let's build something up on the camera left side. So I'm going to anchor the picture. I'm going to say, click on the right-hand side and say, look, don't increase anything on this side. I want it all to increase on this side. And it's only the width that I want to work on. Now, I said that the Generative Fill is the best at 1024 by 1024. And it's always best to have a bit of an overlap so that the technology can see what it's got around it and it can help to blend it all together. Although I want to expand this image, I'm not going to do it to the full size of what GenAI will be good at. I'm going to do it slightly less. So I'm going to make the width 1,014 pixels wider. So 10 pixels, which means when I use the AI, it'll overlap by 10 pixels, which will help it do a better job. So let me just zoom out. So I go for the width at 1014 and click OK. So that now has created that. Now we want to create a selection, all right? It's got to be a square selection. So I get my rectangular marquee tool and I'm going to hold down the shift key. And when I do, we get a square selection. But how on earth do I make it 1024 pixels by 1024 pixels? Very difficult is the answer, but there is a very easy workaround. All I'm going to do is come to the toolbar and come down here where we have the shapes. We've got rectangle, ellipse, triangle, polygon, and line tool. We'll choose the rectangle. All I do then is bring my cursor on top of the actual image and tap down. Then we get this dialog box appear, and all I'll type in is 1024, 1024. So 1024 for the width, 1024 for the height, and then click OK. And that gives us this shape here that is 1024 by 1024. Now, we don't want the shape, we want a selection. So I'll hold down the command key or control key and press down and tap on the actual thumbnail of that layer. And now you can see we've got an active selection just there. Now that we've got that, we don't need the shape. So we'll drag and drop it away. So let's fill it in on this particular area on the right-hand side. So I'll get my move tool, you think, and we'll drag it across. But that does this. That'll cut it out, which I don't want. So to move this selection, this active selection, we'll just go to select, transform selection. Then I can drag it across. And watch this look. As I drag it over, let's close the properties down. As I drag it over to this area here and snap it to the left-hand side, it snaps there. Can you see now, look? See how it's overlapping? That's a 10 pixel overlap just there. So now that we've got that, press enter. We've now got the active selection. We click on generative fill, we type no words, and then we click on generate. And again, we give that roughly 10 to 12 seconds, something like that, to see what it does. All right. And we'll be able to see how the quality now is the same going from the original image over to this new image here. Now that was because the depth of field used on the lens, it was going out anyway, but you can see that there is nowhere near as bad as what that original was. Let's go over to this side here where that is nice and sharp. Let's increase that side of the image as well. Let's go to image and canvas size. We only want to expand this side over on the right. So we'll lock the left-hand side by tapping on the left and we'll say width 1014 again. So we get that overlap and we click OK. So now we've got increased on this side. So now look, watch this. Actually, yeah, watch this. I'm going to open up my actions panel and in here I've got an action called 1024 Pix Generative Fill AI. And look what happens when I press play. Straight away, look, there is my active selection in the middle, 1024 by 1024. I've also got a keyboard shortcut where I can drag it over nice and quick. I'm going to show you how to do that in a second. But look, I'll drag that in, snap it to the right-hand side. See the right-hand side snaps. We've got that 10 pixel overlap. We press enter to commit it. So now we see the active selection. We click on generative fill and we click on generate. Again, roughly 10 to 12 seconds for that to come in. Once this comes in, you'll see that the quality is still really good. And look at that. Nice and sharp. It continues through the grass bits here, the heather, whatever you want to call it. Fantastic. Let me show you how we can create that action. Let me just delete these two layers here. I'll go to my actions panel and I will click to add a new action. And I'm going to call this one 1024 square. So you can see 1024 square there. I could also assign a function key and a color to this, but I won't bother doing that just yet. And then I'll click record. I come over to the toolbar and I choose the rectangle tool. I come into the image and all I do is tap down. That brings in this dialog here, this property box. So in the width, I type in 1024, that'll be pixels. And the height, 1024, and again, that'll be pixels. We then click OK. We now have that shape. We don't want the shape, we just want a selection in the shape of it. So we hold down the command key or control key, click on the thumbnail of the rectangular shape in the layers panel, and press down to load it as a selection. Then we remove that actual shape into the trash can so that we're left with the active selection. So that's all the steps that we need. Let's go back to the actions panel and stop recording and press deselect that there. So we've got this new action, 1024 square. Let's see if it works. We'll press play and there you go. There is our action. Now, the great thing as well to make this even faster, let me just show you this. If I just zoom in, I'll put my cursor over here just underneath the thumbnail. So you can see I'll just rest it there because now look, I'm going to do my keyboard shortcuts. I've got this set up so that to make that action work, all I do is hold down the shift key and press F19. Straight away, there is the active selection. Rather than me now going to the select menu and transform selection, I've set that up as a keyboard shortcut. And my keyboard shortcut, I believe, if I remember, is Option Command F. So now I can just bring my cursor in and drag it into place. So everything now is automated. I'm helping, although I can take a bit of time to build these squares up, I'm still able to speed part of the process up by these keyboard shortcuts. Very simple to do. When you've got your action that's prepared up in the actions panel, if I just zoom in on that, go to this hamburger, or some people call it hamburger, I don't know, these three horizontal lines, tap on that, and then you've got here, you've got action options. And in here, that's when you can say, look, to start the action, I think we'll choose F18 and I have to press the shift key. From then on, when you hold down the shift key and press F18, it'll run that action really quickly for you. And also, if you wanted to set it as a keyboard shortcut rather than going to select, transform selection, I mean, you can know this one. You just go to the edit and we go to keyboard shortcuts and you can see mine in here in the select menu. If I scroll down where it's got transform selection, so you can see there, transform selection, option, command, and F. Whew. So that's that. All right. That's that on Generative Fill. Amazing technology. It's always good to have these little workarounds and have these extra little tools and tips and tricks in our bag. So that's always good.
Join us Photoshop World, September 24th through 26th. Learn more at photoshopworld.com.